System. Author Celso McKenzie. First, a glossary of turnaround terms. Hyphen. This one comes from a professional, and I haven't tested it myself. Lack of time. On series is a sequence of bets, usually one in which the player is in the hole and working towards a profit. You'll hear the term recovery series from time to time, and it tells you that every losing series is assumed to be reversible. There's also an animal called a winning series, more about that later. Don't worry about losing series. Turnaround will run out of money once in a while if you impose a sensible stop loss limit, but it won't happen often. The LTD is a pair of figures you will need to keep in your head at all times. If you can't handle simple mental arithmetic, this method is not for you. If you are a blackjack player who counts cards, relief is at hand. --turnaround is a whole lot easier and more effective than counting and is virtually undetectable by pit cops. LTD is short for loss to date, and the first figure in the pair tells you how many chips you're currently down according to the special tracking method the system uses. The second figure indicates the correct next bet, NB. Basically, your NB stays the same after a loss and increases according to a fixed formula after a win. The steal is a process by which the final profit when a recovery series is resolved is deliberately inflated. When you win, say, 3 units, you steal 1 unit before deducting the win from the LTD and calculating the value of the next bet, NB. Example, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, +1, +3, +4, -5, -5, -5, +5, +6, +7, +5. The LTD after the win that ended a streak of 9 losses was 9,3. Because the single unit won was not deducted from the loss to a date. The NB jumped from 1 to 3 units for reasons I will explain in a moment. The LTD for the series changed as follows: -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, +1, 9,3, +3, 7,4, +4, 4,5, -5, 9,5, -5, 14,5, -5, 19,5, +5, 15,6, +6, 10,7, +7, 4,5, +5, EOS equals end of series. Jumping AND pumping. The jump uses the first figure in the LTD to set the value of the NB. My recommendation is that you do not divide the LTD by less than 6 to get the revised NB, meaning that a 7-bet win streak will end the recovery series. Don't misunderstand the thinking here. I am not saying that 7-bet hot streaks are frequent or even necessary to turn around success. But I am saying that your next bet must always be guided by full knowledge of how much you must win in order to turn a recovery series around and come out with a profit. The pump is another device to maintain the value of the NB at a level that makes recovery attainable. Oscar's +1 after a win rule is pathetically inadequate. It won't get you where you need to go unless the dealer is having a very bad day. When the game starts going your way, you must press as hard as you can, keeping in mind that if you overdo it, a reversal will do you very serious harm. The pump percentage I use is 20%, meaning that after the first win in a potential hot streak, you multiply the previous bet by 1.2 to get the NB. The first win after a losing streak, the previous bet when you're trying to figure the pump, was set by the jump, and now it's time to press a little harder. Here's a sample sequence with the steal, the jump and the pump all in play. 4-9,8, -8, -8, -8, +8, 6-6,11, +11, plus 13, minus 16, 60, 16, minus 16, plus 16, 61, 19, plus 19, plus 23, 21, 22. In this sequence there were 5 losses and 6 wins, but to get you to the opening LTD of 49,8 the house advantage must have been running high beforehand. Generally, you should expect to lose more bets than you win, the casino depends on that. The trick is to make sure that you win more when you win than you lose when you lose, and that's what turnaround is all about. In this example, the 5 losses averaged minus 11 units, and the 6 wins averaged plus 15. That's a good thing. Note that when the first figure in the LTD dropped to 21, the NB became 22 and not 23, times 1.2, 28, applying a rule that the NB after a win can never be less than the LTD divided by 6 or more than the LTD plus 1 unit. More about that in a moment. Next, having. This is exactly what it sounds like. At a certain point in a losing streak, turnaround requires you to reduce further potential losses by cutting your bet down the middle. Again, balance is important here, do it too soon or too often, and your bet will bounce up and down like a yo-yo gone wild, punching you further into the hole with each downturn. The halving rule limits the ploy to bets in double figures and requires you to hold off until you have lost 2 whole bets in a row or, in blackjack, have seen a double loss split raked into the dealer's tray. What you're trying to avoid is the damage from a volley, 60,10, minus 10, 70,5, plus 5, 6-6,11, minus 11, 77,6, plus 6, 72,12, minus 12, 84,6, plus 6, 79,13, and so on, and since paired losses are about half as frequent as isolated ones, the 2 lost bets rule works well. If you can get away with it, keep having until the NB gets down to single digits, remembering that the lower you go, the bigger will be the jump when you finally win a bet and have to recalculate the NB as LTD/6. Here's another example. 169,58, minus 58, minus 58, minus 29, minus 15, minus 8, plus 8, 330,55. It's quite a jump from 8 units to 55, more than a parlay, that's for sure, and in blackjack particularly. You should limit yourself to no more than 2 bet reductions if the pit cops are on heat. The dump. The final turnaround oddity is the dump. Translation, run for the hills. This is a concession to the tendency we all have to beat a safe retreat when a dealer gets hot or our luck runs cold. Computer simulations presume that a player will stick it out through thick and thin, betting bravely onward regardless of repeated punishment and waiting patiently for a negative trend to reverse itself. Human beings just don't play that way. Take a walk if the house gets, say, 10 bets ahead. I'd rather not apply the dump at all, but human nature, mine, at least, doesn't permit me to bet on and on like a senseless robot when I'm getting my butt kicked. So, it makes sense to regulate the bailout process. A guiding principle of turnaround is to provide a rule to cover every situation that could possibly arise in a game of chance, relieving the player of the agonies of indecision. Okay, that makes me a robot after all, but not a senseless one, since all of the system rules are based upon logic and common sense. When turnaround made its debut on the internet in April of 1997, several math-mad computer mavens leaped forward to offer to write source code for simulations which would prove that this particular method of progressive betting is no better than any other.